Hello friends, here in this video we will see a problem on temperature, stress and strain. For that we have a question. I'll write the data what is given here. A square rod 10 mm into 10 mm in cross section. So I'll draw the diagram. Here is the square rod. In cross section. So this gives us the area of the square rod, which is 10 into 10 and comes out to be 100 mm square. Square rod, next, and 1000 mm long, so its length is also given. Is fixed at both the ends. Determine the end reactions due to rise in temperature of 50 degrees Celsius. So delta T is given as 50 degrees Celsius. Take Young's modulus, 2 into 10 raised to 5 Newton per mm square. Alpha, 12 into 10 raised to minus 6 per degree Celsius. So this is the question we have, and here we have to find the end reactions. End reaction I'll denote it by F because it is the force. Now let us try to get the solution for this problem. As it is given that square rod 10 mm into 10 mm in cross section and 1000 mm long is fixed at both the ends. So we can show it in this way. I can explain it with the help of a 3D diagram. Here there is a square rod and it is fixed at both the ends. So we can see that this square rod is being fixed at both the ends. So it means there is a wall to which this square rod has been attached. Similarly, it would be fixed at this end as well. So here is the diagram of the square rod which is being fixed at both the ends. So I'll write down fixed at both ends. Next, it is given that determine the end reactions due to rise in temperature of 50 degrees Celsius. Now what will happen is here there is a square rod. It is being heated. Square rod is being heated, and since it has modulus of elasticity and alpha values, that is coefficient of thermal expansion and contraction, square bar will try to elongate. So if suppose here is this square bar, and when after the heat has been applied, it will try to expand. So this is called as the free expansion of this steel bar, which is delta L. But since here we are having walls on both the sides which are avoiding the free expansion of the square rod, so because of that the stresses are developed in the square bar, and the nature of the stresses would be compressive because it is avoiding the expansion of the square rod. So here the compressive forces are acting over the square bar, and that is nothing but the reaction force F, and that is what we have to calculate here. So when the concept is understood, we can easily start solving the problem. Its original length is L. Now Here we have to find the end reactions. So the first step is, first I'll get the free expansion. I'll say that since the square rod will expand freely before it is being fixed, so therefore free expansion in the square rod is given by delta L is equal to alpha into delta T multiplied by L. So therefore delta L is equal to alpha value is 12 into 10 raised to minus 6 given in the question. Delta T is 50 and the length of this square bar is 1000 mm. So from this I will get the free expansion. My answer is 0.6 mm. So from this it is understood that this square bar would have been freely expanded by 0.6 mm if there were no supports, no wall. But here in this case, since the walls are present, so because of them the free expansion is prevented. So after this I'll write down that since because of the square rod being fixed on both the sides, therefore the free expansion is completely prevented. So therefore thermal stresses and strains will be developed in the square bar. So now I'll write down since thermal strain, or we can say temperature strain, is given by small e is equal to alpha into delta T. This is the formula of thermal strain. So here alpha is 12 into 10 raised to minus 6 and the temperature change is 50. So from this I'll get the answer of thermal strain and it is 6 into 10 raised to minus 4. Now after getting the thermal strain, now I will get the value of thermal stress. So therefore I'll say that thermal stress is given by the formula of thermal stress, that is sigma is equal to stress into Young's modulus, and this has come from by Hooke's law. So therefore I'll get the value of temperature stress. Temperature strain was 6 into 10 raised to minus 4. Young's modulus is 2 into 10 raised to 5. So from this I'll get the answer of stress, that is 120 Newton per mm square. This is the thermal stress which is developed in the square rod. So now as we have to find the value of F, that is the reaction which is offered by the wall, so for that we had calculated the thermal stress. Now we will use the concept of stress is equal to load upon area. That is, I can say that since stress is given by sigma is equal to load upon area, here the load is the reaction which is offered by the wall. So therefore F, that is the reaction, is equal to stress into area. So now F is equal to Stress, it was 120. Area was 100. So from this, F is 12 into 10 raised to 3 Newton, or we can say 12 kilonewton. So now I can say that once the value of F is known, this much is the reaction which is offered by the wall, which is avoiding the free expansion of the square rod. So I'll say that hence the reaction offered by the wall is 12 kilonewton, which will produce compressive stress in the square rod, and this reaction will also prevent the free expansion of the square rod. So, as we have seen in this video, they had told us to calculate the end reaction due to the rise in temperature of 50 degrees Celsius, and we have found out the end reactions which is offered by the wall, and that value is 12 kilonewton. Because of that, there will be compressive stress developed in the square rod, and these values of reaction will avoid the free expansion of the square rod. Because of that, compressive stress will be developed. And with this, we complete the question.